Oh my god, have you seen Mr. Robot?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, how good is it? There's computer science and coding. Oh my god, I really want to learn PHP protocol now and Java. I've really been enjoying it, but I think I might have watched a few too many episodes.
Was Beck just plotting a conspiracy against me? If I didn't take her down immediately, would I be able to get to the truth of the matter and uncover the biggest conspiracy to date?
I can still hear you.
Okay, so not everyone might appreciate super tech nerd show Mr. Robot about a software engineer slash vigilante hacker, Elliot Alderson. But it's definitely done a great deal in bringing computer science out of the basement and into the mainstream. However, the show also needs to hold up as a drama. And so as with all science stories, some facts and accuracies have to be compromised. This is mainly around the way that they depict wireless network hacking and password cracking. So we bring you Everything Technologically Wrong with Mr. Robot. Wireless network, or Wi-Fi, hacking is a far more in-depth process than alluded to on the show. Elliot seems to be able to get into someone's accounts by simply hacking their Wi-Fi, but it's more likely that he would need to hack into the target's Wi-Fi and then separately hack into their computers, IRL. Wi-Fi networks are notoriously vulnerable to hack because most people keep their Wi-Fi configurations in the default factory form. So it's not unreasonable that Elliot could slip into some unsavvy user's Wi-Fi, but that's not a direct leap to having access to the Wi-Fi holder's devices. Once you hack into a network, you often need to get the user's passwords to get access to the device. Which brings us to our next controversy, password cracking. Elliot says outright in the first episode that cracking a password with his password guessing software would take about 2 minutes. Granted, that password was 123456 7, which is super easy and likely to be the first guessed by his software, but it could have been 6x59q hashtag 210 exclamation point for all he knew, and he would have thought it would have taken the same, about 2 minutes. An article on techinsider.com says that the average hack takes days, if not weeks. But is this always the case? The software that Elliot used seemed to be a hybrid, meaning that it used both brute force and a dictionary method of password cracking. Brute force hacking is simply going through trillions of possible passwords until you find the right one, often in the order of several million a second when using a program like Elliot's. The dictionary method is a bit more finely tuned. It uses information about the specific target of the attack to determine the probabilities of that victim's password, using data such as how often the person uses certain keys. So for example, if the person's password is hello, something that I do not recommend you set your password as, the continued use of the letters H, E, O, and a double L would tip off the program that one probable password is hello, and would be one of the first passwords attempted. Nowadays, though, most attacks are hybrid attacks. So in other words, the software enters every possible password to check for accuracy, like in a brute force attack, but it does it with data compiled from a dictionary of probable passwords. This is Elliot's preferred method, and he often uses the social media of his targets as his data to create that dictionary. That said, the average hybrid attack for finding very simple passwords with the 2008 program Rainbow can be as quick as 20 to 30 seconds. So on this controversy, Mr. Robot probably isn't that far from being accurate. So basically, the main problem that we have with the show's accuracy is the time it takes to hack. But since the show has to be done in 60 minutes, we're going to allow them this creative license, especially if it means we get to keep watching Mr. Robot.
Hi everyone, I'm Jayde Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching SciQ, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.